Hello again. We are in the stock market. We are talking about why defining your market is key. And we are coming to a very, very important term here, the so-called product market fit. This is what's going to, you know, be the deciding factor if you are going to be successful in creating a product and service on the market or not. So what does this mean? All the studies say that, you know, the main reason why startups fail is that they didn't find the right product market fit. And how important is this? Well, there is this saying, and I'm just going to read it to you. Assuming the team is baseline competent and the product is fundamentally acceptable, a great market will tend to equal success and a poor market will tend to equal failure. Market matters most. So this is just another argument, another reason for you, another reason that I'm giving you to really let that sink in, how important knowing about marketing and engaging and diving into this, how that product that you are creating actually meets your market. It's the one deciding factor. And I would just love to see more engineers diving into this, being part of that marketing, that sales team that help you shape that product and get into that circle of co-creation with your customers. I know there's lots of really, really important, bright ideas out there and very smart minds carry around. But unfortunately, this is not enough. It's really about finding that product market fit for your product and service. If you want your product to be received on the market. Let me come with another quote for you to understand what it means. In short, I've written here, product market fit is when people sell for you. And okay, that's quite funny, of course, but there's a concrete way to understand this and to visualize this from your own experience as well. So when people understand and use your product enough to recognize its value, of course, you have already hit a huge win. But when they begin to share their positive experience with others, when you can replicate the experience with every new user who your existing users are telling, then you have a product market fit. And at that point, something magical happens. All of a sudden, your customers become your salespeople. Let that sink in. Product market fit means that your customers are so happy and so satisfied, and they find it so useful to use your product or service that they will tell others about it. Very easy term, word of mouth. That's what's selling for you. And that's your goal, to create a product that is received by the people using the product in such a way. To relate this to, you know, something out of the engineering world, you could say that product market fit is also somehow, you know, related to physics. It's finding that resonance with your customers and getting on the same wavelength as they are. Very easy, you know, mind trick to do that if you are your own, you know, using your own product and you are the target group, then you know exactly what that feels like. So I would like to ask you to look at that customer journey again, now in the context of the stock market, that buyer utility map that allows you to go through the specific points and the parameters of your product and or service in the different stages, so that you know how to communicate around this topic to your customers, to understand where to involve your customers, how to actually create an ecosystem and co-create a product on a continuous basis with the people that use your product. That's the holy grail. That's the golden nugget that you need to find when you create something that people actually want and use and talk about. Thank you very much. Now take the next couple of minutes to think about that and to, yeah, take a good guess of what you think is that product market fit for that idea that you have in mind. Thank you. See you on the other side.